Paramahamsa Nityananda, a rare living incarnation, is named among the world's 100 most spiritually influential personalities today. Paramahamsa Nityananda has been placed alongside Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind Body Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages, in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian, and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapitam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
वंदे पाप विनाशकम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् नित्यमुक्तम् निर्विकल्पम् ध्यानलोक प्रदीपकम् वंदे शांतमयम् बंधम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् आनंद गंध संचारम् सर्वोपाधि विनिर्मुक्तम् वंदे ज्ञानालयम् नाथम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् मीनाक्षी प्रणत
next level turmeric balances the irritation. Please understand, your cold and irritation is directly connected. A little bit of turmeric, if you apply it on the body and take bath, whole day you will not have irritation, the mental irritation. And if you can wear the processed turmeric on the forehead, processed turmeric is kumkum, whole day you will be able to maintain yourself with a lot of restful awareness. That is why I insist on kumkum. Understand, kumkum is not just religious practice, it is siddha practice, a technique. Kumkum is nothing but processed turmeric. Processed turmeric is kumkum. And every day, if you can rub the turmeric and apply it on the betel leaf and eat at least one betel leaf, turmeric applied, all the disease related to the water related diseases like a cold or wheezing, any water related diseases will disappear. Of course, wheezing may come under the classification of air related diseases. Water related diseases will disappear and irritation will disappear. More restful awareness will happen in you. I'll go on speaking the deeper and deeper secrets of this turmeric related. Each day I'll introduce one yantra and medicine and technique. Today turmeric is the medicine and chidambara yantra. Please understand, chidambara yantra means creating any line in the inner space by your mind. In chidambaram there is no yantra, it's an empty space. But they go on saying chidambara yantra, chidambara yantra, chidambara yantra means ability to create any clear geometric figure in your inner space is chidambara yantra. Means your awareness should become very sharp in the pineal gland, in the Ajna chakra, so that like a laser beam you can use that in your inner space. If I say create an inverted triangle, just like that you should be able to create. Wow, you are seeing an inverted triangle. So one triangle in the up, one triangle down. If I say wow, you are able to see the two triangle. This ability is what is called chidambara yantra. Medicine is turmeric. Chidambara yantra means ability to create any geometrical figure in your inner space. Tantra technique is as much as possible have the kumkum and keep the awareness that you are wearing the kumkum on the forehead. That's all. Have kumkum and constantly remember there is a kumkum in your forehead. That's all. When you remember constantly there is a kumkum, your awareness gets centered on the pineal glands. You will have the sharp awareness like a laser beam. As on now, a normal human being, if they close their eyes, it's all dark. Like you're driving in a car which has no headlights, the dark road. Then you can't even call that as a road. But if you practice this of keeping kumkum and bringing the awareness to the Ajna chakra continuously, you will have your awareness like a laser beam. If you close your eyes and visualize, try to visualize any diagram, any geometrical figure, you'll just be able to see it. That's what I call chidambara yantra. So turmeric, chidambara yantra, and yantra is chidambara yantra, medicine is turmeric, and technique is bringing your awareness to Ajna as much as possible with the help of kumkum. So this is the practical side of siddha tradition. Modern day youth is really suffering. Humanity has never faced this crisis. I have created a 1-year program where you can study the spiritual truths.
Nitya yoga practices to create healthy body, spiritual discourses to develop mental health, meditations that help balance emotions, Kriyas to break mental patterns that create suffering. Opportunity to express leadership qualities. Techniques that improve creative skills. Learn to break all self-limiting barriers to achieve your dreams. Ananda Yogam.
I am providing a platform for you to think, meditate, contemplate, and decide about your future. I am giving you 1 year free food, shelter, clothes, above all, the spiritual education and intelligence and intuition to take decision about your future.
Every participant is taught the Vedic truths to live life as it leads in a nurturing ambience, along with inspirational spiritual education that helps bring out the best and achieve one's highest potential.
Youth across the world can come and spend 1 year in Ananda Yogam to work on you, to discover your future, to discover your destiny, or recreate your destiny. I'll open my house for you for 1 year completely free. Come and stay here, discover and recreate your destiny.
Interviews at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Bidadi, Bengaluru, 97422-03311.
Siddha tradition, science or magic? I can say the Siddha tradition is science and something more than magic. Magic means appears to be something extraordinary, but not extraordinary. Just simple. Something is being done without you knowing how it is done. It's magic. But there is something called extraordinary, really done. Even if you know, you may not be able to do it. That is what we call miracle. Understand? Magic means, you know, these magicians, how they suddenly bring flower. They don't teleport it. They just take it out from somewhere, from their clothes or somewhere. They hide it and take it out, and you don't know from where they took it out. That's all. Sleight of the hand, it's called. The quickness. Sometimes they show their as if they fly, but there will be a very mild, strong thread on which they will be standing. These are magic. Looks like extraordinary, but not extraordinary. But there is something called miracle. Means it is extraordinary, something really extraordinary, which you may not be able to replicate even if you know. Siddha tradition is science and something more than magic. I'll try to introduce the Siddha tradition to you all more deeply before getting into the medicinal and other aspects of Siddha tradition. Just like Ganges civilization, there was a civilization happening around Kaveri. One fortunate thing with Kaveri is the Kaveri was flowing in the area where a lot of hills, intense, dense forest. Please understand, with the Ganges civilization, it was more plains. And because of that extraordinary floods and Ganges changing the course, and too many rivers, Ganges, Yamuna, tributaries of Ganges, tributaries of Yamuna, the whole thing has become plain. The possibility for forest doesn't exist. But with the Kaveri, is the possibility for forest remained. So this civilization happened in the hills and forest and river. So naturally, the knowledge, the technology evolved in such a way, lot of wisdom, truth about the herbs and the plants started happening in this Kaveri civilization. All the extraordinary achievements, all the extraordinary discoveries happened in the Kaveri civilization were organized and systematized, evolved as a system, as tradition, by a group of enlightened mystics and masters. They are only called Siddhas. I can name hundreds of them. These guys were able to play with their, just with their mind as a tool, they are able to play and do anything they want in the world. And if you see their verses and the techniques they prescribe, still they are working. I don't know after how many thousands of years. Still those medicines are working. Still those extraordinary powers are happening. The techniques they proposed, still they awaken the mind. And the yantras are still working. No expiry date for their techniques. Many of them have mastered the science of handling the body and mind. Even Patanjali is one of the Siddha. Of course, yoga and Siddha always went hand in hand with our Siddha science. It's a system which has evolved solution and answers for everything. Everything means everything. If you want to change the signal when you are driving in the road, Siddhas have a technique. If you are stuck in the railway crossing and if you want the gate to be lifted, Siddhas have a technique which still works. That's a surprising thing. Not just technique. It works. Very powerful people creating very powerful techniques and very powerful tradition. It is so vast. I am really awestruck and wonderstruck. Which part to start first? Which part to next? Because the medicinal part, if I touch, I don't know how many years I have to speak on it. Or if I touch how they awaken the non-mechanical parts of the brain with the herbs, help of herbs, I'll have to speak hours on, or what to say, years on that. And how they create enlightenment pill just through one herb, able to transmit the non-mechanical, the awakening of the non-mechanical parts of the brain in the system.
Sumana asate adhyavo chadadipa भक्ता प्रथमो दैव्यो ऋषभे अहिगश्च सर्वान् जम्बयन् सर्वाश्च यादुत्राण्यः असौ यस्ताम्रो अरुणपुत बभ्रस्व मङ्गलः ये चेमागुं रुद्र अमितो दिक्षु श्रुता सहस्रशो वै शागुं भेडयीमहे असव्यो वसत्पति नीलग्रीवो विलोहितः उदैनं गोपा अदृशन्नदृशन्नुदहार्यः उदैनं विश्वा भूतानि स दृष्टो मृणयातिनः नमो अस्तु नीलग्रीवाय सहस्राक्षाय नीडुषे अतो ये अस्य सत्त्वा लोहं तेभ्यो करन्नमः प्रमुषदन्वनत्वमुभयोरार्थयोर्जा याश्च ते हस्त इषवः परात भगवो वप अवदत्यरनुस्त्वगुं सहस्राक्षशते सुरे निशीर्याणवागुं उत अनेशन्नस्येषव आमुरस्य निषङ्गतिः या ते हेदिर्मे दुष्टमहस्ते बभूवते धनुः तयास्मान् विश्वतस्त्वमर्यक्ष्मया परिभुज नमस्ते अस्त्वायुधायाना तथाय धृष्णवे उभाभ्या उदरे नमो बाहुभ्यां तव धन्वने परिधे धन्वनो हेदिरस्मान् दृढक्तो विश्वतः अतो यदि शुरिस्तपारे अस्मन्निधेहितम् नमस्ते अस्तु भगवन् विश्वेश्वराय महादेवाय त्र्यम्बकाय त्रिपुरान्तकाय त्रिकाग्निकालाय कालाग्निरुद्राय नीलकाय मृत्युञ्जयाय सर्वेश्वराय सदा शिवाय शङ्कराय श्रीमन्महादेवाय नमः नमो हिरण्यवाघवे सेनान्ये दिशां च पदये नमो नमो वृक्षेभ्यो हरिकेशेभ्यः पशूनां पदये नमो नमः सस्मिञ्जराय त्रिषीमदे मदीनां पदये नमो नमो बभ्लुषाय विव्यादिने नानां पदये
As I was telling yesterday, the Navanatha Siddhas, this is what exactly he did to Idaikadar. He just gave the energization. Before giving the energization, he gave an herb to him and he kept the herb on the mouth, gave the energization. See, actually energization awakens everybody's non-mechanical parts of the brain. At least for a second. It's like a diamond shines for a second. But unfortunately, our old ego cow dung is just dumped on it and diamond is covered. With the help of the herb, the Navanatha, he took care that in Idaikadar's system, the brain does not get closed again. The non-mechanical parts of the brain which is awakened becomes alive, kept alive forever. Yesterday one of my Swamis were asking me, Swamiji, you are talking Vidveshanam, Maranam, Agarshanam, Agrushanam from the Siddha tradition. It's very dangerous. If people come to know all these things, what will happen? I tell them, of course, atomic science is dangerous. It can be used for bad and for good. That does not mean we will not discover or make the truth available to the world at all. No. Same way, this is like atomic science. It has to be discovered, revived, and made available to the world. And people should evolve to the level of using this properly, using this with intelligence. But one good thing with the Siddha science, by the time you evolve and acquire all those powers, you get the intelligence also to handle it. when the fools gets the infrastructure in their hand, they swindle the country and destroy all the good and spiritual things in the world. In the real, enlightened beings express these powers, it directly helps the humanity and serves the society. Siddhas do speak about the great techniques and methodology and the science of Vashya, Mogana, Uchadana, Stambana, Betana, Agarshana, Udveshana, Vidveshana, Agrushana, Uchadana, Marana. These are the Ashtakanmas. Vashya, Mogana, Stambana, Bedana, Vidveshana, Uchadana, Agrushana, and Marana. And the Ashtama Siddhis, Lahima, Mahima, Anima, Karima, Ishitvam, Vashitvam, Prapti. These are the Siddhis. It's a science which need to be revived and shared with the world. As I was telling, just this one Siddha tradition, if it is revived, the whole Tamilian civilization will get back to its original glory. It will get back to its original glory. I am not only going to make the Siddha medicines available to the world, I am going to make all the Siddha Kuligas. Kuliga means exactly, the meaning is a particular mental energy is stored in a herb and sealed, and anybody who has that can use that mental energy. I am going to make it available in shops for the world. I am going to do it. All this Vashya, Mogana, Vidveshana, Uchadana, I am going to open it. I wanted the world to know Siddha tradition is not just kind of a voodoo or something like the placebo effect. No, it's a clear science, portable. Anybody can use it. I'll make it as a living science because it is possible. Just through the vibration, a particular energy can be stored in kulikas and it can be transmitted to any being and they can use it. It's like energy battery. Only if the Siddha tradition is revived and brought back to life, Tamilians will remember what they contributed to the world, what they added to the world. This Kaveri civilization is suffering with the cancer of atheism, without realizing what they contributed to the humanity. I'll cure Kaveri civilization's cancer. Through the radiation of Siddha tradition.
The Ingenious Program, a field of all possibilities. The children in the Ingenious Program are directly under the guidance of enlightened master Paramahamsa Nithyananda. Nithyananda is an incarnation and exudes the knowledge of conflict-free living. He states that enlightenment is our birthright. What an incredible gift for your child, a once-in-a-lifetime privilege to live and thrive in the energy field of all possibilities and give enlightenment to your child. Where every child can become a genius. Learning can unveil the genius in every child, provided it stimulates higher order thinking skills, positive self-esteem, teamwork, and an internal locus of control. Research has proven that holistic teaching methodologies paired with meditation stimulate whole brain functioning and result in self-directed, spontaneous, and creative lifelong learners. An enriched environment. When young children have an enriched environment, conducive to early learning in life, they have higher IQ, cognitive intelligence, EQ, social-emotional intelligence, and SQ, spiritual intelligence. These early experiences are critical for the development of the child. Peer pressure and destructive social conditioning can take its toll on the child. It can create negative thought patterns and destructive behaviors unless these enriching experiences are provided. An enriched environment includes whole brain activities which stimulate the utilization of both sides of the brain. The right brain is responsible for creativity, intuition, spontaneity, quantum memory, learning in a flash, and computer-like calculations. The left side of the brain is responsible for inner linear thinking and analysis. When both sides of the brain are integrated, performance is optimal. Brain yoga. Brain yoga activates the ability to balance the right and the left brain. This helps open the sixth sense. Children are given activities to balance both sides of the body simultaneously using distinctive postures that stimulate both sides. The neurological brain patterns move from beta to alpha, increasing alertness and attention. Quantum memory. Quantum memory is a constant downloading of information without interference of the mind. Observation skills are directly related to memory skills. Reading without interference of the mind, reading at quantum speed, will lead to quantum memory without the mind getting in the way. Creative and performing arts. Dance, drama, music, sculpting, and design offered in the Ingenious program provide kinesthetic motor stimulation to engage the brainwave patterns, resulting in expanded creativity and resourcefulness. Sattvic food. Children are given the benefit of fresh sattvic food prepared to the standards according to the ancient Vedic lifestyle. The food is fresh, with fruits and vegetables. Vegetarian food creates radiant health in the body. Vedic cultural arts. Sanskrit chanting stimulates the brain to produce full brain coherence, developing clearer perception and integrated thinking. Chanting also promotes inner silence and improves the attention span. Meditation and expanded awareness. Meditation instills a deep silence in the child, resulting in deeper, richer perception and clarity in thinking. Ingenious produces the next step in evolution, a mature human being who functions at a higher state of consciousness. Expanded awareness provides the platform for a vision of all abilities of life, perfect health, prosperity, and life without conflict. What more could you ask for your child?
If I can just teach this one science to the kids, I will have millions of enlightened beings. Siddha tradition is the only way to cure the cancer with which Kaveri civilization is suffering. All the contributions of Siddha tradition, yoga, rasavada, medicines, and techniques for extraordinary powers, kriyas, processes for enlightenment, and yantras, mantras, everything has to become alive and come to a practical use, so that the Kaveri civilization remembers what it contributed to the humanity and feels pride about its contribution to humanity and revives itself walks out of the cancer of atheism which it is suffering with. All the esoteric, mystical truths, energies expressed by the Siddhas should be available to the world. Yesterday, first time in my life, I said, I am proud that I am a Tamilian. Just because of Siddha tradition. Just because of Siddha tradition, nothing else. And I can see very clearly, all the Siddhas are so happy, alive. Yesterday when I started to speak on Siddha tradition, and I am seeing very clearly, they are all landing here, using this body and this organization as a vehicle to revive, rejuvenate and re-establish the Siddha tradition, their great contribution to the humanity. Today the healing initiation is going to be based on Siddha tradition. I am going to work today, first time, what Navanatha Siddha, Navanatha tried on Idaikadar with a mild herb. I am going to use honey and tulasi. With the help of honey and tulasi, going to make this healing initiation not only permanent, the non-mechanical parts of the brain which gets awakened during healing initiation to remain permanent, so that the transformation which you experience will be permanent in you. Will be completely permanent in you. I do not know what all the great things going to get expressed with the Siddha tradition. I only know one thing. We are going to contribute great things to humanity through the Siddha tradition. All the ashrams, centers of our sampradaya, Nityananda sampradaya, should start practicing, promoting Siddha medicines and Siddha tradition. I'll continue to expand in a detailed way, step by step, in my morning message and the next books, Siddha tradition and the contributions of Siddha tradition to the world will make new health order in the world through Siddha tradition. Yoga, pranayam, kriya and Siddha medicines. With this, we'll make a new world health order. Siddha tradition is not just magic, it is something more than magic. It is science and miracle. I can say science of miracles.
Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bangalore, 562-109. Contact 0974-22-033-11. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.